Hello and welcome to part 4 of this electric longboard build series. Many people, including myself, really want to know if the small DC brushed motor will work. And it does. On a flat surface with my 80 kilograms of weight on it. As you can see, the motor has enough power to get me moving from a dead stop. And it's powerful enough to keep me moving around at a decent speed. As I explained in the first video, I don't want a fast skateboard, I just like the technology to get it to work. But look what happens when I start pushing the board. It's like a pedal assist on an electric bicycle. The only difference is that this board is not limited. And here is another test driver who really likes this board. Now I'm weighing 80 kilograms. My son, on the other hand, weighs 25 kilograms and is a lot lighter, and the board is really moving, as you can see. And yes, it's a little bit too fast to be safe. At full throttle, it reaches 24 kilometers or 15 miles per hour. So after this video, I'm only letting my son ride the board at 12 volt instead of 24 volts. Okay, how does it work? I made a temporary setup to test the brushed motor. With double-sided tape, I arranged all the components on the longboard and connected the wires. Initially, I used the onboard voltage regulator of the Arduino Pro Mini to get the 5 volt that is needed for the current sensor and the Bluetooth transceiver. But after some testing, I ended up using an external 5 volt power supply. The onboard voltage regulator of the Pro Mini could not handle the load in my case. Power for the motor is provided by two 3 cell LiPos with a capacity of 3800 milliamp hour each. They are connected in series, resulting in a 24 volt 3800 milliamp hour battery. In the first video, I explained that I'm using the pulse width modulator of the Arduino to drive the motor. As you can see here on the schematic, a MOSFET is used to supply the power that is needed for the motor. To cool the MOSFET, I mounted it with thermal paste on the truck of the longboard. The diode is used to shorten the reversed voltage. After the MOSFET disconnects the current, a short voltage spike is generated by the motor, as you can see here on the oscilloscope. Without the diode, the generated energy is dissipated in the MOSFET. As a result, the MOSFET heats up pretty fast. With the diode, the reversed energy is removed and all the parts stay cool. DC motors draw a significant amount of current when the rotor is stalled. This motor will spike up to 24 amps. That's almost 600 watts when running on 24 volts. So without any protection, the motor windings will burn in seconds. To prevent this from happening, I added a current sensor to measure the average current through the motor windings. In the software, 200 current measurements are taken every loop to calculate the average current at that moment in time. If the average current is too high, the software will automatically lower the duty cycle of the pulse width modulator until the current is low enough to continue. During this video, by the way, the current is limited to 8 amps and it works perfectly. If I stall the motor and give full throttle, you can see that the duty cycle of the pulse width modulator is increasing up to the point it reaches 8 amps. When I release the wheel, the current drops and the duty cycle of the pulse width modulator increases to 100%. Of course, it's still up to the driver to make sure that the board starts moving. 8 amps without any cooling will still destroy this motor. When riding the board for longer periods, the motor is getting pretty hot. The cause of this problem might be the lack of ventilation. As you can see here, there is a fan in the back of the motor. Its purpose is to create a steady airflow to cool the windings. And as you can see here, the ventilation holes in the front of the motor are covered with wood, so no air is flowing through the motor. And with 8 amps, there is still almost 200 watts of energy that need to be cooled. So if you are going to try this, make sure that you have enough airflow through the motor to cool the windings. One thing that I have changed since the previous video is the toothed motor pulley. This was a 20 teeth pulley and is now a 15 teeth pulley. The motor is running at a higher RPM and the torque is increased. As I mentioned in the first video, safety is important. That is why I added a brake function to my controller. My first thoughts were to short the motor connection with a pulse width modulator. This way the board would have a variable brake. But for now, and for simplicity, I'm using a relay that shorts the motor terminals, as you can see here. Very simple, and it works fine. This relay draws approximately 60 milliamps when activated and can switch 10 amps between the secondary contacts. One of the benefits of electromagnetic braking is that the wheel will always keep rotating. This is because the electromagnetic braking force is zero when the motor stops rotating. To switch the relay with the Arduino, I just connect the three outputs together to share the load. By switching the three outputs high at exactly the same moment, the 60 milliamp current is shared over the three outputs. Now don't use digital write for this. The outputs will be switched on with a relatively large delay, and the outputs of the Arduino can get overloaded. And basically, that's it. You can find links to the Arduino programs on my website. Please note that I'm not supporting this software. I'm just making it available because people will ask for it. So it's up to you to figure it out and to make it work. Links to all the parts that I used and a schematic are available on my website. For the future, I might consider to mount a second motor. One on each truck to get more power and more braking force. Because I'm using the fly batteries from my multicopter, the cost for building this longboard with two motors will still be well under 100 euros. Another thing that needs to be done is to protect the electronics and the battery. But as I already said, this will be the last part of this longboard build video series. So thank you for watching and have a safe ride.